Welcome to Chronicles of Time Sleep Stories. Finding moments of peace in the hustle and bustle of our lives can be a bit challenging. Our channel is your sanctuary, a place where captivating tales blend with soothing tones, guiding you toward restful slumber. Escape from the noise, let go of the day's stresses, and allow our stories to transport you to realms of tranquility and dreams. Whether you're seeking relaxation, meditation, or simply a good night's sleep, you're in the right place. So, settle in, close your eyes, and let the journey to serenity begin. In our unceasing journey through the corridors of life, moments of pure, unadulterated tranquility can sometimes seem as elusive as shadows at noon. The modern world is a symphony of endless noises, from the incessant hum of digital screens to the ceaseless whispers of obligations, commitments, and desires. In this symphony, our souls often search for a gentle lullaby, a melodious escape, a chance to pause, breathe, and simply be. Now, as you find yourself here in the magic of this narrative oasis, know that you've stumbled upon a sanctuary, a world where serenity isn't just a luxury, but a promise. Picture, if you will, a secluded haven, nestled amidst nature's embrace, where the wind hums lullabies, and time itself seems to tread lightly. This is where we invite you to journey with us, a place of meditation, reflection, and utter calm. Begin by taking a deep, resolute breath. Feel the cool air grace your nostrils, traveling through the depths of your lungs, filling your being with the ancient rhythms of existence. And then, as you exhale, imagine releasing the shackles of worry, stress, and the relentless march of time. Each subsequent breath is a step deeper into the heart of tranquility, a dance with the universe, an affirmation of the present moment. We live in an era where the very essence of our existence often feels fragmented. Pulled in myriad directions by demands, expectations, and the invisible threads of technology, it's easy to lose oneself. But these tales, each a gem sculpted from the rich tapestries of imagination and insight, seek to offer you a bridge. A bridge not just to sleep, but that in itself is a cherished realm of restoration, but to a state of soulful relaxation, where the world narrows down to the here and now, where every heartbeat is a reminder of life's simple beauties. These stories are not just words. They are portals. They beckon you into worlds where the pace is gentler, the colors more vivid, and the sounds harmoniously aligned with the rhythms of the cosmos. Here, amidst these tales, you'll find characters and landscapes that resonate with the deepest parts of your psyche, invoking a sense of familiarity and nostalgia. They're like old friends or forgotten dreams, waiting to welcome you back. As you immerse yourself in these narratives, let the outside world fade into soft focus. Envision your stresses and anxieties as leaves carried away by a gentle stream, disappearing beyond the horizon. Let the weight of expectation, the clamor of responsibilities, and the noise of uncertainty be replaced by the soothing cadences of these stories. Every word, every phrase, is a brushstroke painting a world of peace, inviting you to step in and explore. Sleep, that precious gift, is not just a physical necessity but a balm for the soul. It's nature's way of healing, restoring, and rejuvenating. As you stand at the threshold of dreams, these tales are the gentle hands guiding you towards restful slumber. They remind you of the beauty of surrender, of letting go, of drifting into the comforting embrace of night. So, dear listener, as you embark on this journey with us, know that you are not alone. Through the magic of these tales, we are with you, sharing in your quest for tranquility and deep, restorative sleep. Let these stories be your anchor, your lighthouse, guiding you away from the tempests of daily life and into the calm waters of relaxation and dreams. Welcome to our sanctuary. Let the journey to serenity begin. Lost Temples of Zinj. Chapter 1. The Forgotten City. The dense jungles of Africa hid many secrets, and for Jack Harrison, renowned explorer and archaeologist, uncovering these secrets was the essence of life. The sweltering sun bore down as he trekked through the thick underbrush, a worn map in one hand and a machete in the other. His destination was Zinj, a city lost to the world for centuries, a mere whisper in the annals of history. Jack's journey to Zinj was fueled by a blend of rumors, ancient texts, and his insatiable thirst for adventure. The city, according to legend, was once a thriving hub of an advanced civilization, its whereabouts unknown after a mysterious calamity. It was said to house a series of temples, each a piece of a grand puzzle leading to a treasure of unfathomable value. As Jack approached the coordinates marked on his map, the jungle canopy thickened, obscuring the sky. The air was heavy with the scent of earth and foliage, and the sounds of the jungle were a constant companion. Suddenly, the trees gave way to reveal the ruins of Zinj. The city was a breathtaking sight, stone structures and statues, partially reclaimed by the jungle, told of a time when the city was alive with activity. Intricate carvings on the walls depicted scenes of daily life, as well as more enigmatic and mystical images that hinted at the city's secrets. Jack's first discovery was in the city's central plaza, where a colossal statue of a Sphinx-like creature stood guard, its features a blend of human and lion, weathered by time. At its base lay the entrance to what appeared to be a grand temple, its doors sealed shut. Jack laboriously started to decipher the hieroglyphs and carvings that covered the temple. The Sphinx's watchful eye and the numerous temples dotting the jungle floor, each containing a key that opens the ultimate Zinj wealth, were mentioned in the symbols. As night fell, Jack set up camp within the ruins. The jungle was alive with nocturnal sounds, a reminder of the untamed nature surrounding him. He pondered the legends of the Sphinx and the temples. What secrets did they hold? What challenges lay ahead? The next morning, Jack set out to explore the city further. He discovered remnants of homes, marketplaces, and what seemed to be a palace. Each structure held clues, fragments of pottery, tools, and more carvings that pieced together the story of Zinj. However, it was in the palace's main chamber that Jack found his first real breakthrough, a wall covered in a detailed bas-relief. It depicted the city at its zenith and the construction of the temples. At the center of this intricate artwork was the Sphinx, its eyes set with emerald stones that glowed eerily in the torchlight. Jack sketched the bas-relief in his journal, paying special attention to the layout of the temples. it became clear that each temple was dedicated to a different element, earth, water, air, and fire. The bar leaf also hinted at challenges and trials that protected each temple, a test for anyone who sought the treasure. Finally, under the light of a full moon, Jack stands before the statue of the Sphinx. He realized that his journey was not just a search for treasure, but a quest to uncover the mysteries of an ancient civilization. The temples of Zinj awaited him, each a piece of a puzzle that spanned centuries. Chapter 2. The Jungle's Secrets. The morning after his discovery in the palace chamber, Jack Harrison set out from the ruins of Zinj with a clear goal to find the hidden temples scattered throughout the jungle. Each step into the dense underbrush took him deeper into a world that time had forgotten, a world with a line between legend and reality blurred. As he ventured further, the jungle revealed its secrets. The vibrant calls of exotic birds echoed through the trees, and the occasional rustle in the foliage hinted at unseen creatures watching his progress. The map, a combination of the bas relief sketch and his own notes, guided him to the location of the first temple. The Earth Temple was hidden in a valley, shrouded by towering trees. Its entrance was almost part of the landscape, covered in moss and vines. The air was thick with the scent of damp earth. Carvings of animals and nature scenes adorned the temple's walls, speaking of a deep reverence for the earth. Inside, Jack found himself in a vast chamber. The light filtering through cracks in the stone illuminated the room dimly. At the center stood an altar, upon which lay a stone tablet, part of the puzzle he sought. But obtaining it was not simple. The chamber was a labyrinth of traps and puzzles, each requiring a combination of physical agility and mental acumen. As he navigated these challenges, Jack realized that these traps were not just to deter thieves. They were a test, a way to ensure that only a worthy individual could access the secrets of Zinj. Hours passed as Jack solved each puzzle, avoiding pitfalls and deciphering ancient mechanisms. With the tablet safely in his possession, Jack left the Earth Temple, marking the first success in his quest. His next destination was the Water Temple, rumored to be hidden beneath a waterfall deep in the jungle. The journey to the Water Temple was perilous. Jack traversed rugged terrain, crossed swift rivers, and navigated through areas where the jungle was so dense that sunlight barely touched the ground. The constant roar of a waterfall grew louder as he approached his destination. The Water Temple was a stark contrast to the Earth Temple. It was a series of caverns and tunnels, with water flowing through them in a complex network. The sound of water was omnipresent, from gentle drips to the powerful rush of underground rivers. Here, Jack faced new challenges. He swam through submerged passages, solved puzzles that required manipulating water flow, and carefully navigated slippery rocks. The temple's guardian, a Sphinx-like statue, sat at the heart of the main cavern. Its riddle, once solved, granted Jack access to the second piece of the puzzle, another stone tablet, this one etched with symbols of water and life. As night fell, Jack set up a makeshift camp in the safety of the jungle, away from the temple. He studied the two tablets by the light of his campfire, pondering their connection. It was clear that the tablets were more than mere keys. They told a story, one that was integral to understanding the treasure of Zinj. Finally, Jack plans his journey to the next temple, the Air Temple, rumored to be located in the cliffs overlooking the jungle. His adventure was far from over. Each temple brought him closer to the treasure, but also deeper into the mysteries of Zinj and the civilization that had once thrived there. Chapter 3. The Guardian of the Treasure. The Air Temple, perched high in the cliffs overlooking the dense jungle of Zinj, was Jack Harrison's next destination. The journey to the temple was a treacherous climb, with sheer cliffs and strong winds challenging every step. As he ascended, the air grew thinner, and the view of the sprawling jungle below was both exhilarating and daunting. Upon reaching the temple, Jack found it to be a series of open-air pavilions connected by bridges suspended over vast chasms. The wind howled through the columns and arches, carrying whispers of ancient secrets. The Air Temple was a test of balance and courage as Jack navigated the narrow pathways and solved puzzles that required a deep understanding of the wind's patterns. The guardian of the Air Temple, a majestic and ethereal Sphinx-like creature with wings of an eagle, presented Jack with a riddle that spoke of the skies and the birds. Solving this riddle granted Jack access to the third piece of the puzzle, a tablet inscribed with motifs of the wind and the heavens. With three tablets in his possession, Jack's understanding of the ancient civilization of Zinj deepened. He realized that these temples were not just repositories of treasure, but also centers of learning and wisdom, each dedicated to an element crucial to the civilization's way of life. The final temple, the Fire Temple, was said to be located in the heart of the jungle, in an area where volcanic activity still shaped the land. As Jack ventured towards this final destination, the jungle grew denser, and the air was filled with the scent of sulfur. The ground underfoot was warm, and distant rumbles echoed through the forest canopy. The Fire Temple, built around an active volcano, was a labyrinth of tunnels and chambers illuminated by molten lava. The heat was oppressive, and the light cast eerie shadows on the walls. The temple's puzzles required careful manipulation of fire and heat, challenging Jack's physical and mental endurance. In the deepest chamber of the Fire Temple, Jack encountered the final guardian, a sphinx cast from iron and bathed in flames. Its riddle was a test of will, speaking of creation, destruction, and the eternal cycle of nature. Solving this riddle, Jack obtained the final tablet, its surface etched with images of flames and volcanic eruptions. With all four tablets, Jack returned to the ruins of Zinj. He now understood that the tablets formed a map, not just to a physical location, but to a deeper understanding of the civilization that once thrived here. The treasure of Zinj was more than gold or jewels. It was the knowledge and legacy of a people who had lived in harmony with the elements. As night fell over Zinj, Jack pieced together the tablets in the city's central plaza, under the watchful gaze of the Sphinx statue. The tablets fit together perfectly, forming a complete map that revealed the location of the treasure, not in a physical chamber or vault, but within the Sphinx itself. The Sphinx, a guardian of knowledge and protector of the city, opened its eyes, revealing a hidden chamber in its base. Inside, Jack found not gold or jewels, but scrolls, artifacts, and works of art, the cultural treasure of a lost civilization. The real wealth of Zinj was its contribution to human knowledge and history. Finally, Jack takes on the role of guardian of Zinj's legacy. He carefully documented the artifacts and prepared to share the knowledge with the world, ensuring that the civilization of Zinj would not be forgotten again. His adventure had become a journey of discovery, not just of a lost city, but of a forgotten chapter in human history. Chapter 4. The Ancient Treasure. As dawn broke over the ruins of Zinj, Jack Harrison stood in the central plaza, the completed map laid out before him. The early morning light cast long shadows across the ancient stones, and the air was filled with a sense of anticipation. The map, now whole, revealed its final secret, the location of the treasure of Zinj. Jack followed the map's guidance to a hidden chamber beneath the Sphinx statue. The chamber, untouched for centuries, was a treasure trove of knowledge and history. Shelves lined with scrolls, walls adorned with intricate carvings, and artifacts of exquisite craftsmanship filled the room. Jack realized that the true value of Zinj was not in gold or jewels, but in its rich cultural heritage. As he explored the chamber, Jack discovered texts on astronomy, medicine, and philosophy written by the scholars of Zinj. There were detailed maps of the stars as they were known to the ancient people, herbal remedies and surgical tools far ahead of their time, and philosophical treatises on the nature of humanity and the universe. Among the artifacts, Jack found a series of statues depicting the mythical creatures that guarded the temples, the Sphinx, the dragon, the phoenix, and the leviathan. Each statue was a masterpiece, symbolizing the harmony between the people of Zinj and the natural world. The most remarkable discovery, however, was a series of murals depicting the history of Zinj. The murals told the story of a civilization that valued knowledge, harmony, and exploration. They showed the construction of the temples, the daily life of the people, and their interactions with the mythical creatures that Jack had encountered. As Jack documented his findings, he knew he had a responsibility to share this knowledge with the world. The legacy of Zinj could provide invaluable insights into human history and culture. He carefully packed several scrolls and artifacts to be studied and preserved. However, Jack also understood the need to protect the sanctity of Zinj. He decided to leave the city largely undisturbed, a hidden gem for future explorers to discover and marvel at. The chamber beneath the Sphinx was resealed, its secrets safe for another era. Finally, Jack returns to civilization, his heart heavy yet fulfilled. He had uncovered one of the greatest archaeological finds of his time, but more importantly, he had rediscovered a lost chapter of human history. The knowledge he brought back would change the understanding of ancient civilizations and their contributions to the world. Jack's adventure in Zinj had been a journey of discovery, danger, and enlightenment. As he shared his findings with the academic world, the story of Zinj began to spread, capturing the imaginations of people everywhere. And somewhere, deep in the heart of Africa, the ruins of Zinj stood as a testament to a remarkable and enlightened civilization, waiting for the next adventurer to uncover its mysteries.